I came across a video by Veritasium called "Is Success Luck or Hard Work?" And in there, he makes a point where even though hard work is really important, there's still a component of luck that can outweigh the hard work that you have put into something. And I started thinking about if that applies to software engineering and most specifically to app development. So I've compiled some data that I found on Kaggle that has 2.3 million apps that are available on the Play Store, and I started to crunch some numbers to try and figure out exactly the amount of apps that are actually successful or not. And I'm going to go through the numbers and explain to you why the chance of failure is really high, but why that's not an issue. I'm SimCoder, and this is the inconvenient truth about app development. So before starting, we have to define what is successful when it comes to app development. I'm going to assume that every app that has fewer than 50,000 installs is not successful. Unfortunately, the dataset that I downloaded didn't have the data on the active user count, which is the value that actually matters. We just have the installs. So for the sake of argument, we are going to define some parameters before carrying on with this study. I'm going to assume that a successful app has to have at least 50,000 downloads. And I'm going to assume, because I don't have the data on the active users that those apps have, that every install corresponds to an active user. Because remember, an active user is the only parameter that matters when defining if an app will actually make money or not. You can have a billion installs. If you don't have a big number of active users, you're not going to make money out of it, as those users don't use your app, even though they installed it. But for the sake of argument, and to make the best case scenario possible for this case study, I'm going to assume that every install corresponds to an active user. The reality is much worse than that, but let's take the best case scenario possible. Okay, so now that we have our parameter set and that we have a definition for what a successful app might be, which is an app that has more than 50,000 downloads, I believe that after that point, you are able to make some money even with ads. So I'm going to assume that after that point, you can actually break even and make a few bucks on the side for it. So after downloading the data set for 2.3 million apps that are available on Play Store, and I'm not sure if this is completely correct or if there are some mistakes with it, I just have to assume that they are correct. Now we are able to actually start crunching some numbers, and that's what I did. I created a plot for a bar graph, and I came to the conclusion that 90% of apps have fewer than 50,000 downloads, which is, it surprised me. However, when you come to the conclusion that there are a bunch of apps that you haven't even heard of before, just think about the apps that you have on your device. It is probably like 20, 30, 40, which is really far off from the 2.3 million data set that I have. And you have to think that Google Play actually has more apps than 2.3. It is around 3 million at the moment, so it is even larger. But 2.3 million is a big enough number where we can take some conclusions out of that study. So we can assume that when using the real data set, the reality will be pretty much similar. So 90% of apps have fewer than 50,000 downloads. So if every app had just one developer and each developer only made one app, that means that 2 million developers didn't make any money on the app, and it was just a fluke. So now we have to start thinking, why did the 10% of the apps become successful and why did 90% of the apps did not? Well, the thing about apps and launching an app is that, like Veritasium stated in his video, it is not just about how good an app is. There are a lot of things that go with it. The design is really important, so even if the technical side is really spot on, if you don't manage to get a good design, it probably won't be successful, as people tend to look at looks over functionality. Then you have the time where you put the app into the Play Store, that has a really big impact. So maybe if you publish your app in April, it would be really successful. But if you publish your app in January, it wouldn't get any downloads. So there are a lot of factors that go into making an app, and most likely your idea will fail. So if you are watching this video and you are thinking about launching an app, you might think that I'm going to say, don't do it. However, the truth is way more complicated than that. And I'm going to talk to you about my particular case where in the first year of college, I was approached by a couple of guys that had a startup for an app. And they wanted me to join them, so I did. I worked around 4 months in the app, and eventually the app was launched, but yeah, nothing came out of it. And at the time, it was really depressing for me because it was the first thing that I really worked really hard for, and it just failed. However, 1 year later, while watching a Jack Chappell YouTube video, which is a great channel that you should look into if you are into finances and things like that, investments, and he was making a video on why he created the YouTube channel. And he gave such an amazing look into why he created a YouTube channel that I decided that I wanted to do it as well. So later that day, I released my first video. And the funny thing is, I released my first video because I had learned how to use Firebase while working in the startup 1 year before that. And while creating the YouTube video, I didn't make any money for a lot of time, and it was a failure, quote unquote, for some time. However, I'm now working in a company that approached me because I had a YouTube channel. The thing is, even if you don't make a successful app, if you just dedicate time to it and not money, obviously if you dedicate money, then it has some other caveats that are really important to look at. But if you just dedicate time, you will always learn how to do something. So it is not time wasted, it is time that you spend learning a new thing. And you have the 10% chance of actually having a successful app. So does luck play a part in making an app and in making it successful? Yes, it does. However, it shouldn't be a big enough percentage of luck that has to be involved in order for you to just give up on it. However, with the current state of the search algorithms and things like that, well, yeah, you'd have to be kind of lucky to get an app that actually starts trending and actually gets downloads. But there's a lot of work that you can actually put into it to make sure that the luck part of the equation is reduced to the smallest percentage possible. And that's something that I want you to look in: marketing, design, functionality, and timing. Those are the four components that will decide if your app is successful or not. I mean, just look into the big tech companies like Google, Apple. All of them had products that failed. And I would make the argument that they have the most amount of competent people working on products, not just apps, but even physical products like Google Glass that failed completely. And even they are not able to control the timing of the market or the quality of the product enough to make sure that the app is successful or the product is successful. So it is a game of luck. However, if you are able to control the other parameters that don't involve luck, then you'll make sure that your success rate will be as great as possible. And that's something that you can control, and that's something that you should do. So don't ever give up on an app idea. Do it. At the worst case possible, you'll learn how to do something new. And that's something that's really valuable. And I'm not trying to be like one of those really famous YouTubers that think knowledge is everything.
Here in my garage, just bought this knowledge. I'm a lot more proud of these 7 new knowledge.
No, knowledge isn't everything. We have to put food on our tables. However, when it comes to this, by gathering some concepts and actually learning how to do something, maybe next year you'll get another idea where you'll be able to implement it better, faster, and the more that you do it, the greater chance of success you have. So even though 90% chance of failure is not a great percentage, well, It is a shot worth taking, and I hope that you do. So if you enjoyed this video, then please do leave it a like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. I hope to see you again tomorrow. Ciao!